Tired of endlessly scrolling through your long Google Docs? A table of contents is the perfect solution, letting you instantly jump to any section and making your document look professional for printing. In this video, I'll show you how to create, update, and use a table of contents in just a few clicks. Let's get started. I have this document here. It's 4 pages long, and you can see that there's different chapters in it and the subheadings to it. If you'd like to work with this document, I'll put the link down below and it'll create a copy for you, and you can follow along right with this tutorial. So the first thing I'm going to do in this document is actually just go to insert, and I'm going to insert a break, and I'm just going to put a section break here. So just so we have this new page on top. Let's go ahead now and I'll show you where you can insert your table of contents. If I go to insert and then you go to page elements, you'll see table of contents, and you have a few different choices. You can just do it numbered, dotted, or just with links. Now I'm just going to pick this one right here, but you can still change this in the options. Now notice I put the table of contents in, but nothing from my document went into the table of contents. That's because the way Google Docs works, it's really important to understand how the headings work, the heading styles work inside Google Docs. And we're going to start adding some styles to the different headings. Now this across the top, the ultimate guide, is going to be the title. And I'm going to drop down here from where it says normal text, and I'm just going to click on title. And now this is going to be classified as a title. When I go to chapter one here, I'm going to go ahead and select this one. I'm going to drop down and I'm going to click heading one. Now this is kind of large for what I want, so I'm going to shrink this a little bit here. So I'm going to go to 16. I'm going to drop down again and I'm going to go update heading one to match. Because now if I go to the next chapter, I'm going to move down to chapter two. We can go ahead now. If I click heading one, that will match the first one. I'm going to go back up to my table of contents here and look at this. So if I update the table of contents, now I have chapter one and chapter two. So I'm going to go back down to these. Maybe I want some subheadings. So if I go to this one, and this time I'm going to go to heading two. Again, I can make this smaller. Maybe I'll go to 12 and I'll do the same thing, update to match. So if these are going to be different parts where it's going to be heading two now, I can quickly go through and change these to heading two. If I go back up to the top again and I go and hit refresh, you can see how the page numbers are getting inserted automatically. At different times, you can make some changes here. So if I go to more options, you can see if I click on it to the dots, to the links, or back, if I don't want to show the page numbers, show tab leader there. You have lots of different choices that you can do some options to customize this. Now I'm going to go through and just quickly update all my different headings. Now I've gone through now and updated all of my different headings with the styles that I needed. All I have to do is come back up here and hit refresh. Just like that, in a few clicks, I have this professional looking table of contents here. And remember how you can edit. The other thing I want to point out is if I just open this up on the side, as soon as I put those headings in, those styles, this becomes a quick table of contents on the side where I can jump around. So you have some different options how you want to jump around the documents. You could put links in your table of contents as well. You can still add more subheadings below the subheadings that you already have. If I go lower to 3, if I go back up and refresh this again, you'll see that in this case, now this one is indented from it, noticing that it's a different section. So if I wanted to have the title in here, I could make that heading 1 and then the other one's heading 2, heading 3. So some options on how you play with it. I hope you liked this little tip about how to create a professional looking table of contents in Google Docs. Thanks for watching this time. We'll see you next week with more tech tips and tutorials.